Hey guys, it's Diane. I have another video for the wear and tear and maintenance series that I'm doing, and today's video is on Balenciaga bags. And this video is hopefully addressing a lot of the questions that I know people have had and people have requested seeing, and specifically for Balenciaga, how the leather wears in and how to maintain it, and specifically for a few viewers that were used to using Louis Vuitton bags, how a Balenciaga bag would differ from owning a Louis Vuitton. So I will try to get as many questions answered as possible, and then also if you have other specific questions that you'd like to see, please put them down in the comments below and I will try to get to them. I'm going to be doing wear and tear and maintenance videos for specific styles for a lot of the handbags that I own over the next month or so, so I will try to get all of your questions answered. So the bag that I have here is the Balenciaga City bag, and this is from 2008, so this is a four-year-old bag. I am the second owner of this, and I did receive it in use condition, and it gets occasional use for me. So I don't know exactly what kind of use that it got before I owned it, but I do know a few things just from my experience with Balenciaga bags. For a while, I do think that this was a daily use bag with the previous owner. She was the original owner, and she also lived in a warm climate, which tended to be very sunny. So it is slightly faded, and then also I can tell just from use that it has been used as a daily bag for a period of time, and actually for me that is just fine. As a Balenciaga owner and former Balenciaga enthusiast, not that I don't still like them, but you know, I'm not like I used to be, I actually really appreciate kind of the worn and feel of these bags, and I really kind of like the idea of, I don't know, a worn and Balenciaga bag. There's just something very special about it. The leather is it can be described as smushy, drapey, very soft, and especially these bags from, I don't know, I really like the time period around 2007. They did change the leather from 2007 to 2008. There was a switch over there from the Chèvre leather, which it changed to Agnew leather, so there was a change from goat to lamb, and so the leathers are slightly different, but this bag, honestly, for being an Agnew bag, is very gorgeous leather, and reminds me of 2007 leather. So I will get into specific leathers if people want me to in a different video. I just want to generally talk about Balenciaga because that's getting like way too nitpicky and everything. And the main areas of wear on a Balenciaga bag are going to be the handles and the corners, and then just the main area of the bag. And as long as the handles aren't necessarily like sticky or get very black here in the center, you know, it's natural for them to kind of loosen up a little bit and that sort of thing. With everyday use, the bag is going to go from being a unstructured bag. The leather is always going to be soft, but it will have a bit of stiffness to it, and eventually over time it'll just kind of puddle in on itself and be a very kind of soft, unstructured bag. And that's very natural for these. The leather is fairly thin, but it's durable. And I say that it's thin because it's thin compared to a lot of other brands, like Rebecca Minkoff has a thicker leather. Coach bags are generally made with a thicker leather. A lot of comparable brands, you know, Prada bags, Gucci bags, even Louis Vuitton leather, all of those leathers for those companies are a much thicker leather than this, but it is a very durable bag. That being said, there are certain things I just honestly would not do with a Balenciaga bag, hence my reason for kind of switching to more of a Louis Vuitton-centric collection. Not that I don't still love the Balenciaga bags, but for certain things, if something gets spilled on it, it's not going to bounce back like a, well, obviously a coated canvas bag would, or perhaps some other leathers that could be treated a little bit more. The leather isn't really prone to, I mean, if you caught something really sharp, you would maybe have to worry about it tearing. With just general everyday use, you shouldn't have to worry about the leather tearing or getting a hole or anything like that in kind of the main area of the leather. The most susceptible area that you would have to worry about the leather wearing down would be the corners. The corners for Balenciaga bags, no matter how much you baby the bags, with daily use or more than sporadic use, the corners really seem to catch most of the wear on these bags. And for whatever reason, I don't know whether you're brushing up a thing against things or not. It just seems like they get the most use. I have seen on overly used bags where the leather actually wears down to the point that the piping can come out of these areas, but that is really honestly an extreme use. I used Balenciaga bags exclusively for a number of years, and like I said in my Louis Vuitton maintenance video, I consider myself kind of the average handbag user. I'm not overly babying them, but at the same time, I'm doing things to kind of maintain their life, not setting them on the floor, making sure that I'm keeping them out of the elements when possible, and that sort of thing. So really kind of your average handbag user. And I never had a problem in all my years of Balenciaga bags and all of the bags that I had. And I'll post my Balenciaga Gone But Not Forgotten video, if you guys haven't seen it, to show you kind of the variety of bags that I owned. I've never had a problem with the piping coming out of a bag that I owned. So I will say that I do believe that's a rare problem, or in cases of extreme overuse or prolonged use as a daily bag, that will happen. It can be fixed, but don't let it scare you off of owning a Balenciaga bag. Elements. My personal opinion is that the Balenciaga leather is really not as durable to be taken out in the elements as necessarily a Louis Vuitton bag or maybe a Coach all leather bag and that sort of thing. For darker colors, it may not be such a big deal. For lighter colors, especially things like watermarks and that sort of thing, the Louis Vuitton leather is delicate in the sense that you would have to be worried about watermarks and staining from the elements and extreme use. So in very, very cold environments where you have snow and that sort of things, I don't know that I would necessarily take it outside in like a blizzard. And then in very hot elements, like I mentioned right at the beginning, you're going to have to worry about the colors fading, because that is one thing that Balenciaga leathers are known for. The colors do tend to fade and shift over time, and for a lot of colors it's just generally accepted and that sort of thing. But if you live in California where it's very warm year-round, you may have to be concerned with making sure you keep your bag out of the sun when possible. So not leaving it on the car seat where the sun's beating down on it and that sort of thing. So to kind of sum it up, I mean, I know a couple of the Louis Vuitton handbag ladies had questions about, you know, they were thinking about getting a Balenciaga bag and how would it wear in. And I would absolutely say that if you're drawn to the style, I definitely think it's worth trying out. The leather on the bag is going to be very different from anything that Louis Vuitton makes, but it's a very unique, just kind of very gorgeous bag. And I do think that if you are inclined to be drawn to the style, that you will love using it as well. The natural breaking in of the Balenciaga bags is part of their character. It's part of the Balenciaga process. So I wouldn't be scared of using it, of, you know, getting it out and about and breaking it in and getting that natural kind of drapey look to the leather. But at the same time, there are things that I wouldn't do with Balenciaga bags, like overload them for school or travel situations. In my personal opinion, I just feel like the leather is too delicate for that, and also taking them out in extreme heat situations. So if you are looking for a bag to, say, load up with school books or a laptop with a bunch of paperwork and that sort of thing, you may want to look at a different style, just because, in my personal opinion, I feel like they may not be the best suited for that. I know there are people that use them for that, but to me that would kind of fall in the extreme use category. So hopefully this has been helpful. Please let me know any additional questions that you have. I'm going to be doing wear and tear and maintenance videos over the next month or so, and I'm also going to be talking about specific styles. I'm going to be talking more about Louis Vuitton, really, than I am for Balenciaga, but if any of you ladies or gentlemen have questions specifically about Balenciaga, I would be more than happy to come back and do a more than just like a general overview video on it. So hopefully this has been helpful, and thanks so much for watching. Have a great day.